let's talk about the life of the people, occupation and important industries of Democratic Republic of Congo. Democratic Republic of Congo is sparsely populated, or you can say it is thinly populated. There are more than 200 ethnic groups of people who are living here. Ethnic means people who belong to different religions. But the main two tribes which are found here are Bantu Negroes and Pygmies. Bantu Negroes are the people who used to live here. Most of the people who are found here belongs to Bantu, or you can say they are Bantu Negroes. They are very tall and tough, and they have dark complexion and curly hair. They are tall and tough. They have dark complexion and have curly hair. They have their own traditional way of living. They used to live in small villages. Now, some of them have been migrated, or you can say shifted, from villages to towns and cities. As the country is becoming more and more industrialized, so these people have been migrated, or you can say shifted, from villages to towns and cities to work in big mines and factories. Due to hot and humid climate, they wear light cotton clothes. So this is about the Bantu Negroes. Now, who are Pygmies? Pygmies are the original inhabitants of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Inhabitants means permanent residents. They are the original inhabitants of this country. They are short in height. The average height is only 1.5 meters. They are short in height. They have black complexion and they too have curly hair. They used to live in dense forest and they lead a nomadic life. Now, what type of life is nomadic life? Means they used to wander from one place to another in search of food for them and their loved ones. They used to live a nomadic life, and this type of life is such life in which the people, they don't have permanent houses. People don't have permanent houses. They used to move from one place to another in search of food for them and their loved ones. They rarely cook food. They are excellent hunters and they rarely cook food. They used to eat raw food. Right, students? They used to eat raw food. They use sign language. Music, drum music and dance are their favorite entertainment. Now let's talk about the occupation. Farming and mining are the main occupations of the people who are living in Democratic Republic of Congo. Farming is done either by burning the trees or by cutting down the trees. At some places, the forest has been cleared either by burning the trees or by cutting the trees for farming purpose. The main crops which are grown here are banana, vegetables, then cassava, and some other crops are also grown here. Some crops like maize, banana, vegetables, cassava are grown here. Now, what is a cassava? Cassava is a root crop like potato. Cassava is a root crop like a potato, and it is also the staple food of Democratic Republic of Congo. Cassava is used to make bread. From cassava we get tapioca. Tapioca is a hard white grain which is used to make bread. From cassava we get tapioca, which is used to make bread. Oil palm is also used to make cooking oil. Oil palm is also used to make cooking oil, and some cash crops are also grown here like tea, coffee, rice and cotton, which is being exported to other countries to earn money. Now, lastly, we will talk about the important industries of Democratic Republic of Congo. Some important industries of Democratic Republic of Congo are cigarette, chemicals, paper, soap, glass, diamond, etc. These are some important industries of this country. Now these industries are mostly located in the modern cities of this country, like Kinshasa, Lubumbashi and Matadi. These are some important cities of the Democratic Republic of Congo. Now Kinshasa, which is the largest city of this country and also the capital city of this country, most of the important industries are located in Kinshasa. Matadi is a very busy seaport. Katanga is rich in mineral resources. Mineral resources like uranium, gold, silver, cobalt, diamond, etc. are found here. Democratic Republic of Congo is the leading producer, or you can say the largest producer of diamond and cobalt, which is being exported to other countries also. Democratic Republic of Congo is also rich in water resources. There are so many lakes and rivers which are found here in this country. Now, with the help of its dams, it has become the leading producer of hydroelectricity. With the help of the dams which are made on the rivers of this country, this country has become the leading producer of hydroelectricity. Now, the country is becoming more and more industrialized and the life of the people is also changing. Now, there are big cities. They are well connected with each other. This country has a good network of roads and railways. And this country has the good air transport system also. So, this is all about the Democratic Republic of Congo.